Is there something more in that can?
Previously on All My Children.
Are you not going to go to the hospital? He's your brother.
No, Maria. Not anymore.
Amanda needs you. She's a part of you. She's a good part.
$1,000 missing from the cash register.
So we do need a refill of that. How's the cassis?
Check.
Okay, dry vermouth?
Check.
Parachutes?
Hey, you mean the small cocktail umbrellas?
No. The life-saving devices. Your run a plane is equipped.
Yeah, man, it's got a flare, emergency rations, and a do-it-yourself surgical kit.
No buzzing barns or treetops.
Come on, man. Would I play fast and loose with the love of your life?
And you've checked out the weather reports.
Look, I'll check my horoscope, okay? And Haley's horoscope, and the horoscope of the aircraft.
And the wind patterns.
Biorhythms.
You think I'm joking?
I know you, okay? On my honor, as a gentleman and a pilot, I promise I'll stay away from all alien aircraft, I'll steer clear of the Bermuda Triangle, and look, if I come in contact with any other fighters, dude, I'll keep away. Now, is there anything else I could do to make you happy, sir?
Yeah, you can, get a flight simulator and teach my fiancé how to fly on the ground.
Warmer? Warmer? Still warmer yet.
You found it?
Oh, you're not looking for me?
We have a problem.
Waxy buildup already?
I left my purse here last night, and now it's gone.
Oh. Were you sure you didn't check under your car seat?
I was right here at this table, chatting it up with Tanner Dundee.
Oh, well, I'll just ask Tanner if he's seen your purse.
Why don't you check his wallet for excess bulge?
What's that supposed to mean?
Somebody raids the cash register, and then my purse mysteriously disappears. What's the constant here? Mateo's long-lost buddy. I don't know about you, but I'm starting to see a trend.
Legal advice from the district attorney's office. And I guess I have come a long way.
Well, you know, Erica, she can be very persuasive when she wants to be.
Even Erica doesn't tell you what to think, Jack. Thank you for believing in me.
I'm just remaining impartial.
Well, that's saying a lot coming from the DA.
Well, let's just chalk it up to fair play. I mean, you come here without even the benefit of counsel.
And you brief all the people you charge?
No, just the ones that Erica seems to trust.
Well, I think you've made it pretty clear that you trust me, too. You even let me spend time alone with Amanda.
As I recall, you weren't exactly alone, Tim.
But if you thought I was bad for my daughter, you wouldn't have done it. In fact, you'd be doing everything you could to put me away.
I'm not going to take sides here.
Well, that's quite a statement in itself.
Look, Jenny, you're facing the possibility of a very stiff fine, some jail time, maybe both. And this Judge Barnes is a very tough judge.
You're a tough judge, too. A tough judge of character.
You violated the restraining order. That's indisputable. I was just...
But you're still helping me. Tell me, Counselor. What does that say?
Yeah, tell her, Jack. Why are you helping her? I'd really like to know.
Baby. My fault.
Oh,
mine.
All right. It's all right.
Erica.
Yes. I'm right here, darling.
My fault.
Okay.
Forgive me. Please forgive me.
Daddy loves you. Daddy will always love you. You know, Sammy, the world is kind of upside down, but you can always count on your dad. Always. And no matter what happens, even though nothing makes sense, we'll always pull through. I'll always be there for you. You can count on that.
Edmund? What is this?
I'm leaving.
I have to get out of here.
And then can't we talk this through?
In this house.
Please, okay, then let me go with you. Can I go with you?
That's the last thing that I need.
Edmund, we what about Sam's needs? This is his home.
You honestly think that I would uproot Sammy? After all the chaos this child's been through, you think I would be that callous?
No, but I know that you're hurt and you're angry.
So hurt back, is that what you do? Is that how it works? You're hurt, so you hurt your closest family member, you act it out?
Edmund, that's not what I meant.
You just don't have what you need, so you just reach out for the first person that can help you. Whatever it takes, whatever you can grab to get through the night, doesn't matter who you bring down. You start, the going gets tough, you change partners? Is that how you work? That's you. That's my brother, that's not me. Do you have any idea who I am?
Yes, you're the man that I love.
Don't.
You're the man that I have always loved.
I don't want to hear it.
There was not one moment that I didn't love you. Not for a second.
You were devoted for eternity. Except for a few hours in my brother's bed.
I know. And I completely fell apart then. And then
only my brother could put you back together.
But you and I and Sammy are a family now.
Look, don't talk family to me.
We fought so hard to give Sammy a home, didn't we, sweetheart? We fought so, we are his family now.
There is no we.
Edmund. Sammy and we are his lifeline. You and I are Sammy's life.
You and I, two people who never knew each other.
No, that's not true. That's not true. You know that I'm a part of you, Edmund, and you are a part of me. You can walk out that door, Edmund, but you can't break this connection.
Whatever we had, it's gone.
Whatever it was, it's gone. It's gone now.
Something about the baby.
What did I say?
That you wanted me to forgive you. What do you want me to forgive you for?
I don't know.
I think you do. Dimitri, you don't have to protect me. Please stop treating me as if I'm made of glass. You had a nightmare about the baby. The baby was sick. You blamed yourself.
Honey, I have to tell you. I have to...
Darling, I know. Look, you just woke up, or you would remember that we already talked about this before I went away, remember? And I was tested for that blood disease, and I don't have it. Everything's fine. Everything's going to be all right.
This is the hardest thing.
Peggy, hi.
Tell me the old moody timing is still flawless. Hot cross buns. Ooh.
Well, maybe later, Peggy.
They say they have curative powers only when they're eaten hot.
Well, I'm really not that hungry.
Take tiny bites.
I love that. I love that persistence. That's wonderful. Get some nourishment into this man. Peggy, you have my permission to force feed him at any time. I'll be right back.
Well, I'll hold the fort.
You're not leaving.
No, darling. No. I'm just going to check in on Bianca. I will just be a minute and save a bun for me.
Well, Eric is beaming.
She has no idea.
Her mind's on her baby.
You know about the baby?
She couldn't contain herself. Congratulations, Dimmy. Take it as a sign. You made a mistake, but the Lord didn't curse you. He blessed you and your wife. Erica is deliriously happy. Why don't you let some of her joy rub off on you?
But she has no idea what she's in for.
Dimmy, darling. Why does she have to be in for anything?
All My Children, brought to you by Arid Clear Gel Antiperspirant with Double X Protection. liquor store on Fifth and Webb. Somebody ripped it off last week. And the produce mart, Masonic Hall, they think somebody's been siphoning fruit. Shoplifting's up at Pinecrest Mall, and test scores are down in Pine Valley High. I wonder if Tanner's responsible for that new
fine
flu bug.
Fine.
Laugh. I'm not laughing. Dementia's a very serious disorder, Sky.
Fine. Dismiss my instincts.
Right, because they've always been so dead on in the past.
Jonathan made me anxious. I foolishly mistook that for attraction.
Dawn comes to Marblehead.
I learned the hard way not to ignore my radar.
Oh, Tanner's not too hard on the eyes.
Don't be ridiculous.
And he gives you a buzz.
You are
so... your experience tells you that of course he's a snake in the grass.
Something's not right.
Would that be the purse in question?
The purse?
A thousand pardons. I would have called you last night, but I didn't have your number, so... I locked your purse up out the back and promptly forgot about it till this morning, until you walked in just now.
Well, lucky for me, I retraced my steps.
Yeah, this is your lucky day.
I found it on the table. I hope everything's still there.
Seems to be.
Cash, credit cards, family jewels, boarding on the QE2.
This is a big relief. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you for a really rare opportunity. I love to save a damsel in distress.
Why are you helping the enemy?
The enemy? She doesn't even have counsel.
So you're going to give her a little counseling on the sly?
No, I was just taking her through procedures.
So she can proceed to muck up my kid.
Trevor, I thought we were past all this.
Well, as usual, your thoughts are way off. Hello, I'm still waiting for your excuse.
I don't think I have anything to excuse.
No, we really got a problem here.
No, we don't, Trevor. There's no problem. He's not taking sides.
Oh, he's not. Then everything's just hunky-dory, isn't it? The DA not taking sides. That's a neat trick there, counselor. My friend.
I am your friend.
Why don't we dig up your worst nightmare and give it free legal counsel, huh? Denny Banning, how would that be? Let's bring Denny Banning back from the dead.
You're way out of line.
This is still about Laurel and you and me, huh?
Laurel? I thought we put that behind us ages ago.
Then why are you on her side on the aisle?
This is not a trial, Trevor. This is a hearing to see if the restraining order was violated.
If? We're still at if here, like I made this up?
Trevor, all this happened a month ago.
Oh, well, then my memory's fading, isn't it? She didn't stalk my kid, hello?
Stalk?
Amanda who?
I was just hoping that maybe you two could have used the time to come to some kind of understanding.
Yeah, why would that happen? What in hell's bells did you tell him?
I didn't tell him anything about our conversation. The truth is, we did make some progress, didn't we? We shared some things, Trevor. You know we did.
I shared a cigar with a death squad commando in Guatemala once. We had a nice little friendly moment. Then I blew his brains from here to Kingdom Come. Do I have a soft spot? Yeah. Can you work it? Yeah. But not for long.
Everything changes in 97 on General Hospital.
You weren't this angry last time I saw you, Trevor.
No? That's when Amanda was sleeping through the night. Now she's waking up in panics.
What are you talking about? What happened?
Well, I don't know. How should I know? I'm just the father. I've only been taking care of her since day two.
Trevor, please tell me.
And you're the natural birth mother. You should know everything. Why should you listen to me?
But I did listen to you. I did what you asked.
Would somebody tell me what the hell's going on here now?
I wanted to tell Amanda who I am, that I'm her mother, but he didn't want me to, so I backed off.
Not far enough. Not far enough you didn't. Maybe another planet, that would have worked.
Trevor, I can't believe we're back to all this.
And I can't believe how you freaked out my kid.
All right. Is there something that I should know here?
I didn't do anything.
Amanda is afraid she's going to go to jail. She has dreams about being in handcuffs. Mommy's magic touch. You were so sure of yourself. I think it's time that Amanda should hear the truth.
She wanted to know why people call me mean names.
Yeah, the truth, Janet style. I didn't have a lot of friends, so I was bad.
Did you want me to give her specifics?
I didn't want you to get near her. But no. No. Now she's afraid she's going to go to jail for misbehaving. She got a little time out in school on account of a little excessive talking. She's afraid the police are going to find out.
But Trevor, can't you explain to her?
Ah, don't you think I already tried that?
Do you want me to talk to her?
Stay away from my kid. She's Janet's kid, too. Okay. I think we got a couple of solutions here. You either get off the case or I go for a change of venue.
There's no need for that. You know good and well, as long as that restraining order is in effect, I'll enforce it.
Why doesn't that reassure me?
Because I think you know the truth is going to come out eventually, and there's not a damn thing you can do about it.
You keep her away from my daughter, Amanda will forget she ever lived.
And you think that's a positive thing, Trevor, huh? Well, I'm here to tell you, my friend, it is not. Remember, I'm raising a little girl by myself, too. I think I'm a good parent. I think you're a good parent. But you will never be able to fill that empty spot. You will never be able to give your daughter what Janet can.
Oh, yeah, what is that? Advanced crowbar lessons? Bedtime stories
from the
jail
cell?
Oh,
Trevor,
don't
mother's
make
love.
Puke.
Look, Amanda is going to find out. Some little kid in her class is going to tell her, or she's going to find it out in an old newspaper.
I'm not going to let that happen.
You can't stop it, Trevor. You can only postpone the inevitable. And what are you going to say to your daughter when she comes to you and asks why you fought like a madman to keep her mother away from her? Morning, Judge.
Mr. Montgomery? Is everyone ready to begin?
She asked him point blank, why didn't you come to the hospital? Why didn't you come to see your brother?
She still doesn't know?
Eddie made excuses. If she's going to find out, it's not going to be through Eddie. I mean, he'd do anything rather than break her heart.
The way Maria and I broke his.
Oh, Maria'd never say a word. Neither would I. I'd never tell.
Peggy, it has to come from me.
Why? Why? Why do you have to purge your soul? Why not stay silent?
And keep on lying.
Well, live your life. Don't bring it down around you.
I will not follow in my father's footsteps.
Oh, please. You'll go Marek. He had a sadistic streak.
Yeah, and he kept his secret to the grave. I am not going to live my life like that.
Hugo Marek. Your father treated his son like a slave. That's the way he treated Edmund. Now, Maria's child is not going to grow up like that.
Maria's child is mine.
But who's going to profit from knowing this? Who's going to profit from you telling? Just leave it. Let it be. Go on.
Maybe there's a chance that Erica can forgive me. I am not holding out much hope for that, but I have no hope at all if I don't tell her the truth.
Erica's carrying your child. Don't put her through hell.
No, maybe we can go through that hell together. I will not know that if I don't tell her now.
Thank you. Joe, I want to take Dimitri home today.
Oh, no. Tomorrow, maybe, or the day after, if he keeps on improving.
But I'm the medicine that he needs.
Well, you won't get no argument from me there.
Tomorrow morning.
Erica, you're relentless.
Of course I am. It's one of my best traits.
Well, may your child be as headstrong as you are. It takes an iron will to cope with you.
Oh, I forgot to ask. How was Seattle?
Oh, dreadful.
Oh, no. Bianca's upset?
Well, this is what she said. She said, oh, you're having a baby? That's nice. Could I change into my riding clothes?
Well, I guess it could have been worse.
No. Flinging and tears, you can handle. Nonchalance, that's another story.
She's put up a wall. But I do think she just needs a little time to adjust, you know. I mean, my having a baby was a bolt out of the blue for her.
There's a lot of that going on out to Wildwind.
Is Tammy asleep?
It's like clockwork. Halfway between breakfast and his bath. And it's funny how some of the details can stay the same, even though the whole picture shot to hell.
Sammy's not a detail, Edmund.
You know, there's a collection of pictures of the city of Dresden after it was bombed.
Can we talk about the here and now? Right.
Rubble that used to be a fairy tale town.
Edmund,
and in one of the
please.
Shots, there's this limestone mantelpiece. Right in the middle of rubble, and in the middle of this Rebel, there's a clock, a stupid cuckoo clock that is just chirping the time.
I know that you're shutting down on me, Edmund, and I don't blame you. I really don't, because I know you don't want to hear what I have to say.
You know Sam's nursery? You know what that used to be a million years ago? It used to be Dimitri's playroom. That sunny room overlooking the garden was his playroom. It was filled with lots of toys and books and record player and tin soldiers and toy cars and paints and easels. And of course, I couldn't go there, you know. I wasn't allowed in there. I was a stable boy. But one afternoon, I snuck in there and I just jumped into an easy chair and, well, I put on a record. I think it was Shostakovich.
I don't know how to say it.
And for just a few hours, just sitting there reading some books, this world was mine.
I don't know how to make you understand. I don't know how to make you listen to me.
And there was a shadow. And I felt a chill, and I looked up, and there was Hugo. He was just standing right there. He didn't say a word. He just stood there with that look, that sneer of contempt on his face. I will never forget that look.
That was a whole other lifetime ago, Edmund.
This house is a curse. I never belonged here. I never will.
Edmund, everything in this house belongs to you. It all belongs to you, including me. You are the only man that I have ever loved. You are the only one who has ever loved me. And I know I was wrong. But that night that you gave Sam back to Kelsey, I felt like I had my heart ripped out of my chest, Edmund. I was dying. I truly felt like I was dying that night. I felt the way that you feel now.
I waited up all night for you.
And do you remember those nights all those weeks that we spent living apart?
I waited until the morning, just hoping that you would come.
You wouldn't take no for an answer. I thought we were completely done and over with. I didn't feel anything, but you wouldn't take no for an answer because you loved me that much. You wouldn't let go.
I'll never feel that way again. I'll never feel the same.
Not just neck.
Edmund, give us some time.
What can change?
But some of the feelings might come back.
Too much has happened.
But that's... Do you remember I said the very same thing? I said the same thing to you when you were trying to get me to come home. You were begging me to come home.
And you were right. I just didn't see it then.
Do you remember that first night that we were together in the stable?
That was 1,000 years ago.
No, but something happened that night.
We made love.
No, but it was more than that. You know it was more than that, Edmund.
I can't go there.
Remember I told you my deep, dark secret of going out into the night?
And racing Lucinda up to Gracia's horse bareback through the middle of
the night. And when I could look up into the stars, I could feel eternity pulsing through my veins. I felt that night with you. That night, and I feel that to this day with you, Edmund. You were the only man I have ever loved. You are my forever, Edmund. And I can feel it in my soul. I know that I am yours.
I can't get there from here.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Edmund, please, there's so much here to give up. Don't throw it away. Don't. Edmund, please, don't leave me. Edmund, please. Edmund, please, I'm begging you, don't go. Don't go. Please.
I put it out of my mind, Peggy. That night with Maria. But then, a child. And now Edmund knows. I can't go on deceiving myself or Erica.
Well, so be it then.
So be it. Sounds like a passage from The Last Rites.
I don't know. You know, Erica's a very complex woman. No one could accuse her of being naive. I mean, if anybody could understand, maybe she could...
Peggy, I have to try.
Okay, start from the beginning. Tell me everything I missed.
Fill you up?
I beg your pardon?
Coffee, it's on the house.
Generous as well as heroic. I'm forever in your debt.
Sky, can we start over?
Depends on what you like to start.
Well, I only steal old ladies' handbags.
I'm sorry?
No, you're suspicious.
What gives you that impression?
Well, the second I gave you your purse back.
Seen that look before, have you?
You're not the trusting sort.
And what sort are you, Tanner?
I'm looking for a woman with an edge.
Do they like you?
I don't know, but I'd love to hear your opinion.
What makes you think I have any thoughts on the subject?
Oh, it's just a feeling. Am I wrong?
Yes?
You keep saying that. When do you back it up?
How are you?
Frustrated, bordering on angry.
Excuse me.
We have a date.
I'm aware of that.
But not eager or enthusiastic.
I don't react well to pressure.
Well, I don't like being jerked around. It brings out my hostile side and makes me vindictive.
There's no reason to overreact.
This is nothing. Wait till Merrick finds out what you did.
I'm sure that we can come to some sort of an agreement.
You're making me unhappy. You got half an hour to cheer me up. I'm at the lab. Get here.
Look, I'm in no position to...
You were saying?
I have to go.
Oh, good day to you, too.
Hey, do you remember her purse this time?
Yeah, she couldn't thank me enough. Hey, what time is it? I've got to get down to the police station, do that sketch with that artist. I'll catch you later.
Okay.
Intertime, ABC Tonight.
What do you want from me?
I just want a chance to be able to work this through. Please.
Like a project? Clean out the attic and forget that my wife had an affair?
No, I don't expect you to forget. I don't.
Just rise above it and transcend the fact that you're carrying my brother's baby.
That, then please don't stay right here, please, until I get back. Let me just run up and take care of Sam, please. Promise me you'll stay here.
All right. You no matter what.
I don't think I knew until I lost you what forever meant. You're my forever.
Come here. Say hello to our son.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
absolutely perfect. I knew you'd be perfect. Oh, oh, he's such a miracle. He's a miracle. Shelter could use this.
Welcome.
Honey, what's going on?
Our son's home. It's just the three of us now. Hold your son, baby. It's okay. He's not going away.
That the order was in effect when you entered the chairman's office?
Yes.
And yet you entered?
Yes.
Did it occur to you to contact the child care director and ask her to remove the minor child?
It occurred to me, yes,
but you decided against it.
Decided? No. I mean, there she was. My little girl. You know, eyes just lit up when I walked in the room. Could you turn your back on your own little girl?
Miss Green, this court has imposed an order of protection.
But protection from what? I couldn't even bear to hurt her feelings. I can't walk away from my little girl when she needs me.
Miss Green, I appreciate the difficulty of your situation, but we are not here to debate the merits of the restraining order. And in light of your admission that you violated it willingly, I have no choice but to
charges
sentence
withdrawn.
You.
Charges withdrawn.
Mr. Dillon?
We're just wasting our time here. She's... Amanda's in no danger. Janet Green wouldn't harm me. Hair on her head.
And yet, you petitioned for the restraining order.
Might as well try and restrain the wind, huh? Why drive myself crazy? Can we stop this right here?
It seems you are the beneficiary of a sudden change of heart. I caution you. Watch your step. You can't afford another brush with the law.
Trevor, wait! You have a lot to learn about seduction.
We're way past all that.
You think this pushy attitude is attractive?
I gave up on attraction weeks ago.
You have no pride.
But I do have leverage. Would you rather deal with me or Dimitri Merrick?
Look, I still have 24 hours.
Now, I've revised the schedule. You've got 30 seconds to make up your mind.
You have some sort of a death wish? You've seen what my boyfriend's like.
I don't see him now. Do you? The lock on this door is... state of the art. 1,000-pound egg couldn't break it down.
You dare lock this door.
So much for kismet. I'm not the man of your dreams.
I like you.
You used me.
You're very intelligent.
You're a lying tease.
Think about your career. My father owns Tempo Magazine. How does head of research strike you?
Not the payoff I had in mind.
Look, can't we discuss this like two rational people?
Oh, you want to talk? Well, you... have plenty of chance when I tell Merrick he's not the father of that child. What a riveting conversation when he nails you for switching his test results.
Hey,
It's the Gain Ultra.
World News Tonight with Peter Jennings.
Trevor, I don't know how to thank you enough for what you've done.
Stay away from my kid, that's how.
But you dropped the restraining order.
Yeah, that's no big thing either. All it means is when you see a man in the park, you don't gotta go diving in no bushes. Don't change nothing. I don't have no welcome mat out in front of my door. If you start messing around with my kid, I will make you wish I had put you in jail.
But we both want the same thing. Amanda's happiness. We can work together. We can get it right. I'll do whatever it takes.
Getting a secret visitor. She is landing soon. I am picking her up at the airport.
Bianca.
But you guessed it, okay? I didn't tell you. Peggy, you take good care of him now, okay?
Right. I do my best.
All right.
Be careful on the road, Erica.
I always am.
Well, you can't say anything now, I mean. Not with Bianca afoot.
Peggy, there is never going to be the right time. I have to tell Erica.
Excuse me. Dimitri Merrick's room.
Are you a friend of the family?
I have a message. It's urgent. He'll want to know.
Sammy, okay? What was the problem?
Wrong blankie. Oh,
the blue one. I forgot.
Edmund, that night that you took Sam back to Kelsey, I should have come home. I don't know why I didn't let you help me. It was the biggest mistake of my life. Please, don't make the same mistake. Please don't run away. Let me help you. Let me try, at least.
Things down the hall.
You'll stay?
I need some space.
Tune for scenes from the next All My Children.
Stuffy had sore throat, coughing, fever, so you can get through your day medicine.
Tomorrow on All My Children.
Now, I want you to kiss me like you mean it.
Forgive me if I can't exactly envision you up here by yourself.
Who said I was by myself? I'm sorry that this happened.
Well, where's the fifth account?
The ABC After School Special.